Hello, everybody. Welcome. Today, I want to discuss quickly about memorization, because I received yet another question about memorizing, and there's many different tricks that we can have to memorize, but it all comes down to one thing. It all comes down to whether you understand the music or not. And that's what I want to talk about today. Because music is a language, all right? And if you're trying to memorize a text in a language that you do not understand, it will be very difficult, nearly impossible. I do not speak German or Japanese, so if I am asked to memorize a text, a poem, even a short text in German, whatever language that I do not speak, it will be very difficult. I may be able to do it. Will I keep it in my memory for a long time? Probably not. If I memorize the same text or poem in my native language, which is French, or maybe in English, which is a language I can speak and understand, I do not just recite, you know, like phrases that I memorized, that I've learned. I am able to improvise phrases, talk, you know, using words, grammar in English or in French. So I can memorize a text much more easily in English or in French. So if you can understand the music, it will help you memorize it. And I'm going to hopefully demonstrate that in this short video. For instance, if we go here and we have a quick look at Bluesette. First of all, the melody. Understand the melody very quickly. What happens in the melody? Well, let's go and check that out. First, the big notes. The notes that are important. On the first beat of those bars. The important, the strong bars harmonically are 1 and 3 all the time. All right, so let's look. Let's see what's happening here. Okay, and you may already notice that very this melody is something, is doing something very particular. All right, so now if I put this F up an octave, we don't see the rest of the screen, but you can imagine it goes down. So now we see that we're just going down F, E flat, D, C, B flat, B flat, A flat, A flat. Let's scroll down a little bit and we see that we're going down. Sorry, we keep going down to G flat, F. All right, let me do that. G flat. And F, and then we have a little bit of melodic development here, and we stay again on the F. All right, so basically, we're going from F to F. So this is the architecture of this melody. There's something else that is happening in this melody. This is like kind of the big picture of the melody. And obviously, we can go, you know, more granular. And we have different, we have voice leading and so on. But already understanding that, being aware of this, will help you memorizing the melody. Then you say, you see, okay, I'm going up the scale. Very simply, I'm starting on the fifth of the chord, going up the scale. Then I have voice leading, very classic voice leading here. All right, the seventh of the two goes to the third. The seventh goes to the third. The seventh goes to the third. All right, over and over again, same idea. Then there's another voice leading here. The third goes to the thirteen of the dominant seven. And if we scroll down again, it's the same voice leading. You see, the third of his chord goes down to the 13. The third goes down to the 13. The third goes down to the 13. Okay? So understanding that will help you memorize. Now, you may think, oh, okay, nice, you found a song that works like this. All right. Well, my friends, most of the music is based on that. So let me go get another example. This one. Same thing. Let's look at the melody on every two bars. The important, the strong bars. What is going on? The same exact same idea. All right, so this is All of Me. All right, and those are the targeted notes of the melody. So obviously I can go more granular and we have more stuff happening in this melody, but again, I can notice that I'm going down the scale. C, B, A, G, E, D, C, B, A. And then I go back up and I end up on the on my starting note. All right. Okay, so we saw that the melody is following very specific guide tones. Now, every song is going to have different architecture, but many songs will share the same architectures. All right, now let's go back to Bluesette and see, I think it was 69, and look at the harmony, understanding the harmony. Because same thing, look at this. And next, in your real book, you go next page, Blues for Alice. Do you notice something? Do you notice that the harmonic progression is identical? Let's look at this. We are in B flat, B flat, and I'm going fast, okay, because that's just, I'm just trying to demonstrate that. That's our one chord, one major seven. Okay, then we have A half diminished, that's the seventh chord. All right, flat five. D7, that's a secondary dominant, that's a five of six. Five of six, oops, like this, five of six. Then here we have six minor seven. C7, that's another secondary dominant, that's a five of five. Five of five. Here that's 5 minor 7, and here we have the 5 7 of 4. Here we go to 4. 4 minus 7, and then flat 7 7. Okay, let's stop here. And we have our 2 5 relationships, all right, and then 5, okay, 2 5 of 5 and 5 of 4. All right. Okay. So you see that we have to deal with a lot of 2 5s. So if you really practice your 2 5s, well, my friend, you'll be good to go. Okay. But most importantly, here 1 2 5 of 6 2 5 of 5 2 5 of 4. So we start on 1 and we end up on 4 through this series of 2 5. 1 2 5 of 6 2 5 of 5 2 5 of 4. Okay, now let's go to the next page, literally the next page in your real book. Okay, now we are in F major. What are the chords? 1 major 7. 7 minor 7 flat 5. A7 5 of 6. 6 minor 7 5 of 5. 5 minor 7 5 7 of 4. 4, and here we have the same thing, 4 minus 7 flat 7 7. It doesn't, then the rest is not the same, but the first bars of Blues for Alice, all right, half of this song is identical to half of Blueset. 1 major 7 2 5 of 6 2 5 of 5 2 5 of 4, and then 4 minor 7 flat 7 7. Okay, again, check it out. 1 major 7 2 5 of 6 2 5 of 5 2 5 of 4 4 minor. All right, I go back to Blueset, which is right there, the page before. 1 major 7 2 5 of 6 2 5 of 5 2 5 of 4 4 minor 7 flat 7 7. Identical harmonic progression. Of course, those are different chords because we are in a different keys, but this is the same harmonic progression. All right, so you have to understand that, and then that makes it easier to memorize. Okay, now, and I'm going to finish with that, we go another song. Let me see, to let me try to find it real quick. There Will Never Be Another You, and you can imagine that this is going to be the exact same progression. Now we are in E flat, 1 major 7 2 5 of 6. Okay, now we're skipping the F7, but actually you could play F7 here, all right? That would give you a 2 5 of 5 2 5 of 4. Same progression. So already Blueset, Blues for Alice, There Will Never Be Another You, same progression. And you can find many other songs that will share this same progression. So if you understand that, then you can memorize it. If you do not understand, you will be able to memorize it, but it will be much more difficult. And most importantly, if you improvise, then you will not be really able to improvise melody that makes musical sense and that will sound good. All right. Okay, my friends, so that's it for now. I hope this helps you understand the music, understand the melody, understand the harmony. It will make your life easier to memorize it. If you have any question, let me know. I'll talk to you soon. Take care. Bye-bye.